نحمد ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Honorable viewers to ITV, Subhanallah, we are on the days of Hajj. And myself for 10 years, Alhamdulillah, Allah has afforded me that honor, the opportunity to be of khidmat, of service to the Honorable Hujjaj of South Africa. That indeed is one of the great blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I've enjoyed the winter nights of Cape Town. I've enjoyed with the homers of days and nights in Makkah al-Mukarramah, Madinah al-Munawwarah. May Allah ta'ala accept, inshallah. This year, of course, not only myself as a khadim, but even the hujjaj that were credited for this year, they have in their hearts, they're feeling a bit heart sore and a bit down. Because they prepared everything, as Allah says in the Quran, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ زَادَ التَّقْوَى, that make your preparations. But ultimately also the best of preparations is your patkos, and that is taqwa, the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they prepared in every aspect. And as we know in Cape Town, they've come for 6 months or even a year or 2 years in advance. Courses, not crash courses, proper courses A to Z of the Hajj, the nitty-gritties of Hajj. Alhamdulillah, in the midst, in our presence here, we have our honorable young leader of the community by the name of Qari Hafidh Salim Peck, Maulana Salim Peck, Hafidhahullah. Young, dynamic, did his Hafiz under the late Sheikh Yusuf Buli, one of the great, great pioneers of the Quran. Nawar Allahumma Marqatahu insha'Allah. Amin ya Rabbil Alameen. So ahlan wa sahlan to our honorable Qari.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Maulana, and to all the viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Yes, Maulana, alhamdulillah, we find ourselves in these days of Hajj. And we can only imagine what these people are going through, the Hujjaj that had really prepared themselves for, you know, months up leading up until now. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests us with this COVID and lockdown. You know, we can be sure that they are experiencing a lot of mixed emotions. But rightfully, as Maulana said, that the best preparation for them and for all of us is that of taqwa, that we are always to prepare ourselves regarding our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in that regard, the Prophet ﷺ beautifully tells us in hadith that how amazing is a believer, a person of true belief and iman. His situation will always be amazing. And this is not for anyone if that person is not a true believer. And what does the Prophet ﷺ say? In asabathu sarra'u shakara fakana khayran lahu. If it is good times, then he makes thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He uses those good times to strengthen his relationship with Allah, and that is good for him. And if it is bad times, says Nabi Muhammad ﷺ, in asabathu darra'u, if there are bad times that happen, sabara, he bears patience and he perseveres for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ, so that will be good and best for him. So yes, to all the hujjaj, subhanallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen you and increase you in fortitude, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you a much greater substitute than, you know, what we thought we were perhaps going to achieve with our hajj that we would have performed this year.
Subhanallah, so well explained by Honorable Hafidh Qari Salim Peck. And it reminds me of a hadith where Rasulullah said, As-sabru nisful iman, as-sabru diya. That sabr is half of iman. Wal yakin al-iman kullu, but to believe insha'Allah, I am going to say my labbaik. And your labbaik has already started with your intention. And your labbaik is every namaz, every salah, where you're conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As our Honorable Maulana Naeem Mutala Hafidhahullah mentions the important 7 T's, the T, A, B, C, D, T of taqwa, of consistency, During the days of Dhul Qa'dah, Dhul Hijjah itself, not only in the Ramadan, taqwa is not only in Ramadan, but also the pre-run for the months ahead. And subhanAllah, my respected friends, and what is that? The tea of taqwa, the tea of tawbah, the tea of tilawat of Quran, of tazkiyah, subhanAllah. These are very, very important ingredients for us, tasbihat after every salah, because these are a podcast that's going to be very useful for us for the journey of Hajj, inshallah. So with you having patience, Allah gives you a glow, such a glow that you can, a next Muslim can see on a Hajj already. There's a signs of labaik. May Allah Ta'ala make it easy for all of us, inshallah, as the dua says, Allahumma inna nas'aluka fi safrina hadha al-birr wa taqwa. Oh Allah, let this journey, once a Hajj is going to be accredited, or once a Hajj is then eventually after, for if not this year, next year, inshallah, and if not next year, the year to follow. And if perchance anything happens to you, Allah Ta'ala forbid, but if anything should happen to you, you'll be written with talbiyah. You'll be raised with talbiyah. That is the power of one's intention, inshallah.
Yes, Mawlana, subhanAllah, the intention extremely important for all of us. And it's something that we can even extend further than our hujjaj themselves. But every single other person, every single other Muslim that had, chosen this beautiful kalima. So one of my friends has been Muslim his entire life, but he many times refers to the day that I became Muslim. So what that he means, but the day that I dedicated myself and Allah Ta'ala blessed me with this realization that I am on a journey with Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala and I am going to meet Him, and I thus have to prepare for that meeting. And may Allah Ta'ala bless us all with this particular seed of Iman that we can, recognize that we are going to meet Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. And if we have that realization, Mawlana, then, whether we are going to be going on Hajj this year or not, or whether we have intended Hajj or not, at this point in time, we are conscious of the fact that we are traveling towards Allah. And if we are conscious of that fact, then we will try as best as we can to adjust our entire lifestyle so that it can facilitate that meeting with Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. So may Allah Ta'ala grant us that. May Allah grant that we can live full lives with a beautiful intention that we want to take every aspect of our life and we want to be able to present it to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, so that we can show, Ya Allah, on those days that I went camping with my family, I still try to be conscious of you and I try to make that a preparation for you. And the days that I went to masjid with my family, I took my children with to teach them about the importance of salah. And that is what I wanted to leave them behind with regarding that. And when I took my older children for their job interview, then, I tried to make them conscious of the fact that Allah is the one that is going to give them their rizq and not the job itself or that income. So, in this way, when we can, align that intention that Mawlana spoke about, we can make every aspect of our life an aspect that will be a preparation for our meeting with Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala.
Yes, my dear friends in Islam, as our Honorable Qari has just left us also with our meeting with Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. And that's why Allah encourages us, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ زَادَ التَّقْوَى. Have ready your provision. How ready are we to meet Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala? And Hajj being one of the five pillars of Islam, one of the biggest dreams of each and every Muslim, because it's a journey of hearts. The soul longs for Arafah. Al-Hajju Arafah. So Hajj actually is that day when Allah gives you that acceptance to be on Arafah. And Hajj, my dear friends, is the place of all prophets. Our beloved Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, recorded by Abu Sa'id Khudri radiallahu ta'ala, that Allahu Azza wa Jal says in Hadith Qudsi, in Abdan sahahtu lahu jisma, that my servant, my slave, I've given you a strong body. وَوَسَعْتُ عَلَيْهِ فِي الْمَعِيشَةِ, and I've given you a good job, as Sheikh just mentioned now. But you always have in the back of your mind, shukr to Allah, shukr to my parents, shukr for my healthy body. Wow, wow, I've got it, alhamdulillah. And you're earning well. I've got a quiet house, I've got a quiet phone, I've got a quiet car, I've got quiet mags. You've got everything lekker. You started the fishing rod, you started a small boat also for fishing, a yacht, alhamdulillah, you got all these things. Now Allah Ta'ala says, when I've given you a good body, I've given you a good start of a family and the start of a house and income, alhamdulillah, 5 years pass. Allah says, I give you 5 years. Allah's had lekker on your liver, and 5 years is coming by. And you forgot to say shukr at my door, to knock at my door. You haven't made intention. You've gone Maldives, alhamdulillah, with your family. You've got pictures here of ha-ha and ha-ha, but you haven't got to labbaik, Allahumma labbaik. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, you're only depriving yourself. Hajj brings barakah, maftarak al-hajj. A haji, poverty never comes to your door. Inshallah, we pray and make dua. Allah Ta'ala give us all that intention that I want to undertake this journey for the sake of Allah. Because, my respected friends, if you haven't gone for Hajj, then you have not really traveled. Wa ma tawfiq illa billah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.